What is up, my brother, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memory. Alright guys, so guess what? This is going to be our last session for this playthrough. Now, I don't know how many episodes I'm breathed into, but this is going to be our last session. I'm completing the rest of the game here and now. And it's going to be... I don't know what to expect from it. I mean, this is all Kingdom Hearts 3. But then it's this one that worries me. Why, the last song, the last thing to do. But we're going to see what happens, guys. So we're just going to start this off. No. What was it? Never mind. Alright, Toy Box. And it's only one song. You got a friend in me. Da 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 da. It's a movie. Okay. 55% or more hits. 300 targets total. Slide targets? Okay, cool. And we're gonna do it on this one. And we are going back to my boys, Sora, Donald, and Goofy, because they play Kingdom Hearts 3. So that's exactly why. And we're gonna take off. Keep some potions on, I guess. Alright, let's go! Alright. So we're doing a movie? For Toy Box? Okay, cool, not bad. I guess y'all can enjoy the things while I have to focus on this, huh? Oh, one mess up there. Alright, so did you guys like... Did you guys enjoy Kingdom Hearts 3? I did, man. I can't tell a lot of people that, because what do you mean you enjoy Kingdom Hearts 3? It was such a horrible game, man. It was not a horrible game. I mean, it wasn't the best game. That honor goes to Kingdom Hearts 2, but... But, like, you gotta understand, man. Like, there's no reason to hate a game because it's not to what you're expecting it to be, man. Judge a game by, like... But, like, what the game was like, or... But I mean like gameplay. Don't judge the story. No, not really. Don't judge the story of that, man. Like, cause then it's gonna turn into Last of Us. Like Last of Us 2, man. I know a lot of people didn't like Last of Us 2. It was just a good game, man. It got Game of the Year first. So just be considerate of what you call what's a bad game or not. Kingdom Hearts 3, like, it was not that bad of a game. It was a really good game to me, and everyone has their opinion too, right? But like, the people who went into that game thinking full well it's not gonna be Kingdom Hearts 2, right? And that's what really sucked. And then they beat it, and then I was like, yeah. Just what I expected, right? Like, you didn't even give the chance it deserved. A lot of people did not even give The Last of Us 2 the chance it deserved, man. The Last of Us 2 is a really great game. It's, man, you go in there for the story. Gameplay is good. You go in there for a story, though. And let me tell you what, story on Last of Us 2 was really good. So, I mean, y'all can take that how you want, but yeah. 30 hit. What's hit targets like? I don't know. Oh, well, we did it. Yay!
To prepare for the final battle with Master Xehanort, Sora set out in search of a way to regain his power of waking. In Olympus, he learned to fight for someone with all his heart. In Twilight Town, he searched for clues about Roxas. In a fairy tale kingdom, he met one of the new Seven Hearts. And in Toy Box, he learned hearts can reside where you least expect them. Meanwhile, Lee and I were hard at work training to become Keyblade wielders. And Riku and Mickey found a clue to where Terra was.
You know, the King of Toys, concerning the story of Kingdom Hearts 3, I liked it, because it was like, it was cool, right? Think about it like this. So, it was the end of an era, bro. This part of the story took, what, freaking, at least some, I want to say 20, but I know that might be like going a little over. I want to say close to 20. Somewhere around 20 years for it to be finished, for Xehanort's story to finish. And you know, now that it is finished, now we're going on to this new story where Sora is like gone. And I don't know how to explain that to you, but Sora's gone, and we're trying to look for him now. Now that the world's gone back to his peace, there's like no more Heartless. There's like everyone's all chilling. There's no need to fight anymore. Then Sora just appears, and I'm like, ah, shit. Now we gotta go do this, and that's the story now. So. Respect on Kingdom Hearts 3 for ending off something like that and getting us into something new, because who knows? Kingdom Hearts 3 could have been the very last game, but who knows? Alright, what is this? Kingdom of Corona. Oh, yeah, that's a good name. difficult? Okay, I got the proud mode on this. Alright, let's go. Alright, y'all, enjoy. Y'all sit back and enjoy the movie. Y'all enjoy Tangled, bro. I enjoy Tangled. I think it was like one of those old classics that we learned, but it's like, but it's a good movie nonetheless, bro. Oh, there's my little bitch ass in the back. I messed up. Oh gosh. Whew! Hit that one off, hell yeah. Oh gosh. Bro, I think I said this back then, and I'm like, on my Kingdom Hearts 3 bit playthrough, right? But like, yo, these movie ones, they were crazy. Like they look like they got taken straight out the movie. That's probably what happened, but. But yo, like these, like the worlds, all the cutscenes and stuff for Kingdom Hearts 3, they look like they got taken straight out the movies, man. And I'm like, Jesus, this is like, this is too close to what it actually looks like, isn't it? Because back then, Kingdom Hearts, when they went to their worlds, right, and did their movies as some of the story, they look like very different, and they did it differently. But like, Jesus Christ, these are the Kingdom Hearts 3 were like really just like dead on. Straight from the movie, even the animation looked like straight from the movie. The voice acting was not, but Jesus. Nice, key art. Oh, that's recoded. So So I noticed that we're only doing one song. These guys. Oh, we got Monsters, Inc. We got Frozen. Oh, my gosh. How cool it was for Frozen to be. You remember when Frozen was first announced? It was like the craziest thing in the world. Well, that same day we saw Aqua turn dark. But, like, it was still crazy. Think about one song, yeah. Oh, we're gonna finish this easy today, aren't we? Like, it's all one song. Monstropolis. Ooh, let me talk about Monster. I'll talk about Monster Jinger in a second, but alright, we can hit all this. Proud mode. I mean this mode because it says we can't. Alright, I know a lot about this controversy. Did you like Monsters, Inc.? Monsters, Inc. to me is one of the most memorable movies I will have from my childhood, man. I don't think I can ever forget about it. Now, Monsters University. I liked it. But, like, I know a lot of people didn't. Because, like, what was it, man? It was a prequel. But it was, like, the college bullshit that drew everybody off. I hit that, whatever. I don't know. I liked it. It had, like, a good... It was good sensitively, you know? If that makes sense. Damn it. Ugh, what the hell? They're trying to trick me here, man. Wonder, like, back then, I didn't really care, right? But, like, now, I was kind of, like, seeing these movies in Kingdom Hearts 3. Then I'm thinking, like, yo, I wonder how hard it could have been to get the original voice actors for characters, you know? Like Sully and Mike did not sound... Not sound like anything like what they should have. I don't think anyone did, man. I think maybe either. I think only ones that really sounded like them was it was Anna, Elsa, Buzz, and I would say and Rapunzel. Yeah, and maybe everyone from Big Hero 6. That was about it. but that was about it. Everyone else sounded like they were close enough, right? They were close enough. But everybody else sounded like, you kind of a little more work on the accent or like a little more deeper voice, stuff like that. But it was fine nonetheless. It's just like a small nitpick. But I didn't even wonder. Like, I wonder how hard it is to get like their real voice actors to do these roles. But then, like, that's our thing, like, there's a reason why they're not there in the first place, so, yeah, I might as well just shut up. The Lump of Horror. Monstropolis was not that hard of a world, even though I know I died a few times on it. Really? Is this song? I kind of figured, but, oh my gosh. I didn't want it to be this song, you know? And I gotta do it on prod mode. Oh god, this is gonna be fun. Bros. So, okay, Frozen 2 is... it's an okay movie. It's not the best one, though. Frozen 1 is much better. I'm gonna get copyright so much. I'm gonna get copyright for hell after this song, man.
Like
Nice, nice. You just heard this girl sing on top of the mountain, like. Let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. I mean, what are you gonna do, man? Well, now they know. Let it go. Let it go. That's what I'm talking about, man. It's straight from the movie. Ah, damn, I messed up. My bad. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. Yeah, like this whole cutscene was straight from the movie. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small. And the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. Nice. Ah, come on, I press the button. Let it go, let it go. I'm one with the wind and sky. Let it go, let it go. You'll never see me cry. Okay, hold on, man. I'm messing up here. Okay, hold on. My soul is spiraling in frozen fractals all around. And one thought crystallizes like an icy blast. Okay, hold on. A little break. Nice. Okay. They kind of messes up a little bit in the middle, but we're good. Alright, like I was saying, Frozen 2 is not that good. Frozen 1 is better. Let It Go was a popular song at first, then it got overused. That's all I'm gonna say in the matter. Back then when we first watched the movie, hell yeah, it was fun as hell. Now it's cool, but like maybe 2 months later after Frozen was first came out. Let It Go, ooh. Let It Go was too much. It was everywhere. And then Frozen 2 could not beat Let It Go. I'll tell you that much. Their songs were not that good in Frozen 2. None of them tried. None of them could beat Let It Go. I'll say that. Okay, Skull. You know this boss is actually pretty cool. I like them. Oh damn, the key like Gregor already. Damn, we already here? Oh, it's open! Oh, Sephiroth! Who are you? Oh, that's Vanitas! Holy hell! Oh, I might have to do like a bonus extra episode! Hold on now! I'll see. San Francisco. Robot Overdrive. Yeah, I actually did like Big Hero 6 World. It was really big. I mean, like, really big. Pause. the rainbow, they fly a target. Okay, these are awesome movies. Am I gonna fight somebody soon? Like, we're just flying through air, listening to songs. You're not complaining, but. I need to go back and play Kingdom Hearts 3 again. I'm not gonna lie. I need to go do critical mode with only Keyblade. All right, so Big Hero 6. Good movie or not, man? Honestly, I don't hear a lot of people talking about Big Hero 6. Like when it first came out, I went to go see it with my brother, and we had a fun time watching it. It was nice. It was fun. But like after that, I never heard people really talking about it. I know people like Baymax, and that's about it. That's like. I never hear people talking about the actual movie. But I think it was a good movie, bro. It was a really good movie. Bro, it surprised me a lot of times, I'm not gonna lie. Maleficent, man, what the hell? Yeah, Maleficent didn't do anything in Kingdom Hearts 3. I'll let y'all have that one. Hey, Maleficent and Pete didn't do a damn thing in Kingdom Hearts 3. Oh yeah, there's two Baymaxes now? It's crazy. Yeah, there's two Baymaxes now. That was really crazy in that one. Pull chain, that was easy as fuck. Yeah, like it was cool because Big Hero 6 World, it was actually a sequel to the actual movie. It's not canon, but it's a sequel to the movie. But and it was really cool because now like they had the new Baymax, and then they got the original Baymax back, and it was like really nice. And the original Baymax was like evil and corrupted and stuff like that. And it was just really fun to do that world. I mean, the flying segment in that world kind of messed me up in my own playthrough, but it was nice. Story scene. Aw, this scene, man. You're gonna pray. You're gonna make me cry, man. Don't do this to me.
Sora's journey continued. In Arendelle, he encountered a love true enough to thaw a frozen heart. And at the Laughter Factory in Monstropolis, he learned that Ventus resided within his heart. In San Francisco, he saw hearts that were being constructed from data. Meanwhile, Riku and Mickey were forced to confront Aqua, whose heart had fallen into darkness. With some help from Sora, Aqua was finally able to return to the Realm of Light. And the Land of Departure returned to its former glory. Ventus awoke thanks to Sora's regained power of waking, and he was able to save Aqua from Vanitas.
Man, it was... Oh my gosh, Dark Baymax. So, Dark Aqua, man, my heart broke that day. I saw her become Nordic, bro. She wasn't even Nordic. She was just filled with darkness like Riku did, man. It was so crazy. And I was like, yo, not my girl Aqua. Aqua's been through the most in this game, bro. No cap. In the Graveyard Labyrinth. You know? Coming here and back in Breath by Sleep was crazy. I'll let them have this one. Oh look, it's an after walking one. Nice. We should get to do some fighting. Alright, let's do this. But man, Aqua had so much of a hard time in her journey through Kingdom Hearts. Okay, man. Ah, what? How did that happen? Bro, that messed me up so bad. What the hell happened? Back off! Baraga! Arx Arcanum! What the hell? It wasn't even... This was Prama. Okay, yeah, it was Prama, but Jesus Christ, what was that, like, beginning part, though? This is a short song, too! Like... Graveyard Labyrinth. Did we even get... Oh, we got all three. Okay. I'm not complaining. I never questioned it before. But, like, when the world did have more than one song, right? How come there was no, like, next song option? Except, instead, you had to go to a world tour, to the world map, and then go to the song, go to the world again, and then go to the next song. It would have just easier to add a function where you can just go to the next song immediately. Trust me, it would actually save a lot more time of editing. Melody of Past Light. Rise of the Union. Oh. Oh, okay. Okay, I get it. Okay, let's go. Alright, let's see what we're up against here. Oh, hell no. You see all those Heartless, bro? What? I hit that. Thunder. Get back. Okay, what's going on, man? Okay, what's up, man? I keep hitting those spots. I'm not hitting them, apparently. Back off! Woo! What was this song? This song was crazy! There is so much coming at me! I had to get the potion! That's how crazy it was! Jesus Christ! Alright, Rise of the Union. Not bad. 55% or higher. Okay, whatever. We can work on that some more time.
Darkness will prevail, and the light expire. It all unfolded just as the Book of Prophecies foretold. But Sora refused to give up. His heart persisted against all odds. He used the power of waking and fought long and hard to save his friends. And so, the Light's defeat was overwritten, and the Guardians of Light reassembled at the Keyblade Graveyard. The deciding battle with the true Organization 13 was about to begin. As the battle raged, Terra, Roxas, and Shion were revived and joined the Guardians of Light. But Master Xehanort still succeeded in summoning the true Kingdom Hearts. To stop Kingdom Hearts from unleashing its power, Sora went to the ancient city of Keyblade wielders, Scala at Kailum, and the final battle began. As the fierce struggle ended, Master Xehanort gave up the Keyblade and abandoned his plans. Kingdom Hearts was sealed away. But it was still far from over. I had disappeared during the battle, and Sora was determined to bring me back. He set off on his journey once more, alone.